man. He's been overseas for the troops 5 times. You can catch his stuff on Sirius XM. So, ladies and gentlemen, Marc Yaffee. Woo-hoo-hoo.
Lux Devereaux, right there. Let him hear it. Yeah. Lux Devereaux, Montana Blackfeet. Marc Yaffee. Yeah. Blackfeet in the house. Marc Yaffee, California Sioux. Yes. So far, I've sued Walmart. I've sued McDonald's. I'm suing my damn agent. He booked me in Tulsa, Oklahoma during rodeo week. Me and 3,000 drunk cowboys. You do the math, Wordley. I felt like Michael Vick working at Petco. It's all right. You can laugh at Michael Vick jokes. He served his time. 14 dog years. All right. Where are my people at? Where are my... Cheese-eating, fry-bread-making, casino-owning, first American, pre-Columbus, aboriginal, indigenous, Native Americans at. Make some noise. Where are the skins in the house? All right. There we go. We are going to party like it's 1491, people. Hey, do you have any of the other Indians up here? The other Indians, turban Indians, not urban Indians. Where they at? Microchip, not buffalo chip. You got any of those? Tech support, not child support. Where... I asked an Indian man from India, how come your Indian people never come to our Indian casinos? He goes, oh, no, 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 my friend. We are not going near those places. My cousin Sanji programmed those damn slot machines. So, hey, you think they celebrate Columbus Day over in India? They should. They dodged a bullet on that one. Columbus went the wrong way. Columbus... Some craziness, huh? They say Columbus went the wrong way and discovered North America. My cousin drove the wrong way. He discovered jail. It wasn't even a hit and run accident. It was a hit and stay. We know this, though. It's a historical fact. The U.S. government tried to kill off minorities. They gave African American syphilis. They gave Native American smallpox. They gave Asian Americans driver's license. The Asians love to gamble, don't they? Have you seen them change lanes? No, I did that joke in San Francisco. One Asian guy was pissed. He goes, that's not funny. I'm going to run you over with my Honda. He goes, you got a big head. You got a big bobblehead. Look at my big ass head, people. I was but 13 pounds, 10 ounces at birth. I was delivered by forklift. 13-pound head, 10-ounce body. I was like a globe on a Q-tip. Embarrassing, man. I couldn't walk till I was almost 3. I couldn't hold my damn head up. So I'm the quarter blood of the group. We got any quarters out there? Or my slicers? Anyway, fraction Indians here tonight? See? Because we're not bragging about that one too much. Quarter bloods, we're like the Rodney Dangerfields of Indian country. Like, no respect, no respect. I tried dancing at the Pow. They said, sit down. Our people have suffered enough. No respect. I went to the 49, they'd only serve me your duels, no respect. I went to tribal health, I asked for a doctor, they gave me a Dr. Pepper. My agent, he's crazy, my agent sent me to Iraq in August of 2009. I give it up for all our troops serving overseas, the Middle East, Afghanistan. Hey, and keep clapping for all our veterans. I know we got some veterans out here tonight. Let them hear it. Right, man. Because they make it possible for me to stand up here and make a jackass out of myself, right? No! Yep. So we're over there, and we're in Iraq, 134 degrees. It was so hot, my poop melted. I saw a camel's hump evaporate. Iraq, all desert, no gambling, no drinking, no women showing any skin. It was like being in Utah. We got to cheer them up over there in Iraq, man. Pull out all the troops, get rid of the foreign aid. Just open a chain of Hooters. Yeah. They'd be like, welcome to Baghdad Hooters. They're like, all right, check out the Achilles heel on her. Yeah. Then my agent, he sends us to Japan. The Japanese are crazy. They're into anything American. They're into hip-hop, gangster rap in Japan. Yeah, biggest rapper in Japan, 50 Cent, or he's just known in Tokyo, City 7 Yen. I like rap, but I think the rappers need to change it up. They're going to have to start adjusting their names, and they start hitting 80, 90, 95 years old, huh? I think when he turns 80, Ice Cube is getting downgraded to a warm puddle. To Busta Rhymes, become Busta Hip. Eminem's become Enema. And P. Diddy's going to be Diddy P. I love rappers. I got rappers from all over the globe now. Sweden, Germany, Australia. They got a rapper from India. India. His name is Slurpee G. I heard him on satellite radio. He's like, cruising to the store in my 924. Got my shotgun and my turban, so you best not be disturbing. Shit, I gotta... You guys ready for the holidays? You guys, yeah, I got a big exciting New Year's. I'm going to be in Duluth, Minnesota, yeah. Because my agent doesn't subscribe to the Weather Channel. Last time I was in Duluth, Minnesota, minus 36 degrees. With the wind chill factor, minus 2 testicles. I heard of blue balls. That place is ridiculous. Shoo, my junk disappeared behind my spleen. It didn't come out till Groundhog Day. I had the worst case of male Minnesota camel toe ever. So we got any of my people here tonight? Any Mexican, Irish, Navajos? Any Mexahos? Aztec, Navajos? Any Azhos? Now, how about any hoes? Do we have any hoes? Any hoes? I did that line in San Francisco. 8 Asian folks jumped up. Ho family! Eto, here for the show. San Francisco. Last time in San Francisco, I'm checking into my hotel room. I asked for a non-smoking queen. Yeah. Here comes Leo, the tobacco-chewing cross-dresser. Yeah, so I'm not from the res. I'm originally from northern Mexico, or as the rest of the country calls it, Los Angeles. Yeah. They're still talking about building that damn wall. They want to build a 3,000-mile-long wall, 30 feet high, between the U.S. and Mexico. What a waste of money. You build a 30-foot-high wall between the U.S. and Mexico, Mexico become the largest producer of 31-foot extension ladders. Pole vaulting become their new national sport. They'll be like, yes, we can. Si se puede. Really? 3,000-mile wall ain't going to stop crap. 3,000 miles of shark-infested waters and a leaky boat did not stop the pilgrims. Or as we like to call it, the worst surprise costume party ever. Yeah, I know. You just got people. You just can't keep blaming everything on illegal immigrants. That's my neighbors. Oh, damn illegals coming over the border, taking our jobs, driving down the price of wages. Like, bullshit. Illegals from Mexico aren't driving down the price of wages. Methamphetamine addicts are driving down the price of wages. That's right. Who else going to get to cut my grass for like $2 with scissors? Hard times. I was in Las Vegas on the Las Vegas Strip. Guy holding a cardboard sign. Homeless, hungry with puppy. Some jackass drove by in his truck. He's like, eat the puppy. It is. It's tough times right now, people. It is, huh? Yeah. That's right. Obama promised us change. Yeah, because we're all out of cash. Nah. 2010 is historic, huh, man? Obama's in the White House. OJ's in the big house. Tiger Woods got his ass kicked out of his house. 8 million Americans lost their damn house, huh? No one saw this one coming. The Europeans took the land from the Indians so it could be landscaped by the Mexicans and foreclosed on by the Chinese. If this keeps up, hey, if this keeps up, Indians are getting Manhattan back for $24. And the beads. I saw in the paper, Obama wants to start trade with Cuba. What does Cuba have that we need? Cigars, sugarcane and cigars, right? Just what America needs, more diabetes and cancer, right? I'm like, all right, Obama, you want to have trade with Cuba? How about this? We'll take three left-handed pitchers. They can have Rosie O'Donnell and the Jonas Brothers. Hell, throwing Justin Bieber, he's not even American. What the hell is it? Adios. Jeez, man. I think someday, though, it's, you know, we elected a black president. Someday we're going to have a native president. It's going to happen, people, right? Yeah. That's going to be a whole new operation. They're going to White House will become the Long House. Rose Garden will become the Corn Garden. All the state dinners will be potlucks. Basketball tournaments every weekend in the White House gym. So yeah, like I said, I wasn't raised on the res, not raised traditional. I was actually adopted out at birth by a Jewish father and a Mexican mother. I'm an adopt-a-ho, yeah. Jewish father, Navajo son, that makes me a bargain hunter-gatherer. See? You can't even adopt an Indian child from their tribe anymore, right? Indian Child Welfare Act. That's right, they passed that law to protect our people from Angelina Jolie. Crazy though, man. People treat native folks different than they treat any of us. They walk up and say things to Indian people they wouldn't say to anyone else, right? Like, you know, the one always like, oh, I'm part Indian too. You can tell by my high cheekbones. What? You wouldn't do that to me. You wouldn't walk up to a Jewish person. Hey, you can tell I'm part Jewish by my large wallet. You can tell I'm part Jamaican by my high THC level. Treat is different. I'm working in Reno, Nevada. Housekeeping found out I'm native. The next day, they showed up at my door. The lady starts knocking on my door. She's like, hey, I said, excuse me, sir, you want more teepee? Six in the morning, get the hell out of there. I want some more damn sleepy, all right? Trying to economize, get through the times, man. Shit, I'm trying to economize. I get rid of my little pickup truck. I bought a Kia Rio. Anyone else driven the Korean lawnmower with a windshield? That's right. I'm not even from the res. I drive a Korean res bomb. Anyway, Kia Rio, that's Korean for top speed 45. Even Korean people are like, oh, dude, you screwed up there. You a loser. He's driving the Kia Rio. That car's embarrassing. You get on the freeway in a Kia Rio, you get passed by Winnebagos and wheelchairs, and retired Amish people. So we got any of my people making up here? Any Dene up here? Any Navajos up here hiding out till your FTAs come off your record? Where you at? Always, yeah. I love it, man. Navajo Nation. I was down in Navajo Res. We have a zoo on the Navajo Reservation. Yeah. Yeah, native zoo, res zoo, man, and then that's a res down too. First of all, I don't think you can call it a zoo if you have like three sheep and a wounded possum, right? I said, this isn't a zoo, this is a potluck, what the hell? And guy's like, oh yeah, that's our zoo, you want to make a donation? I bought him a cat. What's your closest Walmart up here, Indians? Where you? How far you got to drive for that? An hour for Walmart? Nah, that's not fair. Half an hour, okay, she's driving really fast right there. You'll get on my way. I'm passing on the double yellow. I don't give a crap. I gotta. Yeah, there you go. Yuck foo too. All right. Why does every Walmart have like 198 disabled parking spaces? You go to the Walmart. You ever see that? Any Walmart in the United States, four of those spaces are ever occupied. They need to share those other empty spaces at Walmart with some other needy people. Like you ladies on that special week of the month. Full parking privileges. You wouldn't need any special license plates or parking placards. You would just tie a tampon on your rearview mirror and come on in. No dumbass is going to fight you for that space. Shit, I went inside that. I hadn't been in the, like, down the women's aisle. And like, fellas, you been in their women's aisle? Like, I call it Kotex Town? She's... I've been there for like 8 years. They've redecorated. You women have like a variety pack now for that week of the month. They got a variety pack. It's got almost everything in it. It's got mini wings, maxi wings, ultra wings. Like, geez, throw in some buffalo wings because she's pissed and she's not cooking. Craziest feminine product of all, a scented pad. Scented pad, that's like flavored Q-tips. Scented pad, nobody's sniffing around here at a time like this. That's like one big police crime scene. No man's going in for at least a week. Yeah, I'm married. I'm married. I'm still married because neither one of us wants custody of the kids. Yeah, I got a mixed marriage. I mean, I got my wife's paranoid schizophrenic. I'm obsessive compulsive. Yeah. She invites over imaginary friends. I make them take off their shoes before they come in my house. Shit, yeah, my wife's crazy though. She's like one of these animal rights people. She likes these little dogs. Have you heard these little dogs called Maltese? Yeah, it's a little, yeah. Maltese, that's a French word for shits all over my carpet. Man. 5-pound dog, 10-pound dookie. If you've never heard of a Maltese, it's a little white dog with clingy fur that stick to the wall when you throw them. No, I'm just kidding. I've never laid a hand on those dogs, right? I use a leaf blower. Ladies, clap your hands if you got a little dog at home or in your purse right now. Where you at? See? Look at. You love those little dogs. I see it right there. Oh, my baby. Probably your screensaver on your phone, your little dog, huh? You women have unconditional love for your little dogs. My wife's dog could crap on the couch, barf in the kitchen, hump the neighbor's leg. I'm like, geez, I'm not even allowed one of those things. Man, I leave the toilet lit up. I'm cut off for 3 weeks sleeping on the damn couch. Meanwhile, precious the Maltese on my bed, teabagging my pillow. Sitting on that damn couch watching way too much TV. I got the Dish Network, 500 channels. It's ridiculous. Almost every group now has got their own network. Black folks have BET, shoppers have QVC, Mexican Irish Navajos, they got Court TV. Oh, True TV. It's time for all Native American television network, TPTV. That's right, I'll do the programming. Well, our shows will be Survivor Reservation, Wheel of Misfortune. Whose land is it anyway? That's right. I will have comedy on my Native network, too. I'll do a spinoff to the old Beverly Hillbillies. Be Native style. I'll be like, well, listen to a story about an Indian named Fred. And Ogallala Sioux always kept his family fed. Plenty of good fishing and a lot of buffalo. Till a white man came along and said, you gotta go. But you're still here, Coeur d'Alene. Give yourselves a round of applause. Thank you very much. I'm Marc Yaffee.